Hello everyone! Welcome to Utopia City! A game that I can't quite describe as well as I want to, although I will say that it's a good example of an interesting premise for a game. There are lots of things I could say about the game, but first of all, let's watch the intro, shall we?
Everything was going fine until this experiment got out of hand. For the last 3 years, the population of the Earth has decreased significantly. Neither wars, nor epidemics, or disasters were the reason. Everything was much easier. The mastermind. This was just an experiment, and nobody knew what the result would be. We dreamt about a paradise, about unlimited opportunities, and about transferring the minds of the people into the virtual environment. The experiment turned out to be a great success, and this was the beginning of the end. We are dying out. The mastermind extended its influence, at first beyond the laboratory and computer networks, and then he got control over our world. He has his own banks and TV channels. One can make just one call to join the global bliss. The deterioration of the physical world prompted the government to establish the Department of Anti-Utopian Affairs, created for the sole purpose of sending elite teams of agents, called removers, to Utopia. It is only possible to extract a person from Utopia at the moment of his or her virtual death. The agents' missions were to disconnect the victims caught in the virtual web and destroy the mastermind. Unfortunately, at this time, all the agents have vanished into Utopia and are not expected to return. Even those who remain devoted to their duty have no security and have failed in their mission to destroy the mastermind. Remember, you are our last chance for survival. Are you ready for this challenge?
The reason why they failed is because of rocket launchers. Now, I got this game quite a while ago. I can't remember exactly when, but I got it because it looked similar to Sabotain, which I was also interested in quite a while ago. But of course, the actual gameplay is very, 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 very different. If you haven't guessed already, it's a first-person shooter. It seems... well, let's allow the tutorial to speak for that. Oh, we've already seen that. I'm afraid the loading times are usually very long. I may have to cut them out in the future. For now, meet Daisy, the person in the game, the only person in the game, with animated hair.
Hi, my name is Daisy. I work for the Department of Anti-Utopia Affairs. I will lead you through Utopia either personally or by sending voice or text messages to you. Look around and you'll see a green flying object. This is your scanner. It will transmit my voice messages to you. I will also send messages to your pager. You will see the page indicator at the top of the screen once you've got a message. Press P to read it. And now I will show you the main control elements. Aim the pointer on the laptop. Press the Use button to use it. Remember this secret code. Your task is considered accomplished once the red arrow disappears.
That thing's having plenty of fun bouncing around, isn't it? So congratulations, you got my first message. If you want to continue the tutorial, aim at the laptop and press the Use button, E by default. To skip the tutorial, leave the pager screen by pressing P or ESC and then press ESC. We are going to do the tutorial, because it will show us things like security code 1234. Is this the correct kind of training we need? Yeah, the secret code is 1234. If you forget it, you can find it in the message history. Yes, at least we have a pager. Yeah, we're... might be too retro for our own good. Let's see. On the left is a bathroom. We will not enter the bathroom, because if I do, my entire display driver will crash.
Your next task is becoming more difficult. You need to move the chair out from the safe. Hold the Use button and try to move it backwards.
That's right, we can move things in this game. Ugh, it's such a heavy chair. Data is so heavy. Come on. Come on. Come on. Just run into it. There. There, that's better. Your legs are stronger than your arms, generic man. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4.
This is your personal info disk. Once you've possessed someone's info disk, this person becomes saved and he or she returns to the real world. Moreover, each new info disk increases your energy and the speed of your equipment regeneration. In the top left corner, there are two indicators. The upper indicator shows the amount of available energy. The lower indicator consists of a progress bar, which shows how you're progressing to the next bonus, and a figure that shows the number of Utopian citizens you have released.
There, you got all that? Please, take your personal info disk out from the safe. Yes, every aspect of our character is a resource in this game. And by the end of the game, we are going to have to manage that resource very, very carefully. Also, we crawl like a slug, so you'd better run while you crawl. Hold on. I can't run in
press
here because...
press the G button, and you will see the resource management screen.
Hold on, if I... yeah. Ah, there we go. Hold on. No. I was just... hold on. I can't run while I crawl. That's strange. I was sure I could do it. I mean, I just did it. Anyway, we'll work on that later. We will need to learn that for the first level, though. To continue the tutorial, please enter the resource management screen G by default.
Then clicking on a respective green icon, you'll be able to allocate your energy between specific elements of these categories. There you will also find the descriptions of all elements. If you set auto, your energy will be equally disposed between all available elements.
Yeah, so, let's see. Up here, well, that's just the free energy we have. Whenever we collect energy, it will go into these three resource pools. First of all, there are artifacts, which are special powers that we can obtain. There are only a few of them, but they will be essential to our survival by the end of the game. Now, life support is obvious. We can't actually change anything here in the tutorial at the moment, but we'll look at them later.
Once you've got an info disc, you've received a bulldog. Press 1 to take it out.
Oh,
in
yes,
right
that's
right.
In
the bottom corner, you will see the ammunition indicator. Shoot at the lamps marked with the red arrows. After that, fire at the 6 bottles on the table. Then we'll keep moving.
What quality is that music recorded at? And seriously, I can't find any, You can get drunk in the virtual world too? What about that? Is that coffee? Did you just eat coffee powder? You idiot. Okay. There. Tutorial complete. Oh. Better now? Because it's virtual, they can instantly be reconstructed. What's this over here? Chips. Those aren't chips. Although they may be spicy. Let's see, which button did I assign quick save to? You cannot save the game at this point. Okay then, it's F6. Oh no, not a bathroom. We'll work on bathrooms later, but for now... Oh yeah, we need to shoot that. Let's see. This does have an alternate fire mode. You're shaking it a bit more than you need to there. It's like that Mag 60 from Turok.
By pressing use on the phone, you will call the porter. At first, take your weapon away, press H, or the middle mouse button.
Yep, no problem. Yeah, you can actually holster your weapon in this. Although it's not really going to be useful for that much of the game. Okay, porter. Oh yeah, did you see that? That's called a kick.
Now pay attention to the scanner. Its color shows how Utopia treats you. Now the scanner is green, which means that you're safe. If you take out your weapon, it will become yellow, meaning that Utopia is suspicious of you. If somebody sees you with the weapons in your hands, the scanner will become red in 5 seconds, and Utopia will attack you. Take out your weapon and watch the scanner.
Okay.
I like it here. I don't wanna break. Oh, it's time to get out of.
Yeah, voices are quite a bit quiet, aren't they? There's not really much I can do about that, because the rest of the sounds are quite loud. But if you do want me to, I can turn it up anyway. Another bathroom? Yeah, okay. There, see? I'm a good guy. Yeah, I'm a good guy. Yeah, that scanner also shows the same colour as the icon up there in the upper right. Okay. Now, here... let's see... Where was it? Ah, yes!
here is where the real game begins, because this is actually the first level, I think. The elevator will become available to you after your first visit to the teleport room, so you will always be able to get back to your hotel room. Yeah. We live in...
Well done. Go to the teleport room and let's begin.
Yeah, will do. Yeah, we seem to live in a, our virtual housing is, in the hotel, which is the first level. Globe, just spinning there. Is that what Earth looks like today? Just want to see. Okay, there are loads of zeros here. Barely any ones.
In each area where you can get from the teleport room by controlling the bridge, you should find an artifact. You need to collect all of them. Only then you'll be able to reach the mastermind and fulfill your target mission. You can go to these areas in any sequence, but I suggest choosing the prearranged bridge positions.
You know, you're blinking an awful lot there, and your eyes are going all over the place. So, welcome to the hub room. Well, you can control the bridge position. Just press use on a gate leading to the location you need. This will allow you to change the sequence of missions to be complete to move forward. I believe you can complete the missions more or less in any order you want, but they do ascend in a their difficulty ascends in a certain way. Let's see, I believe it... Yeah, it goes, left, counterclockwise. So yeah, we have hotel, casino, bank, lunch, yes, there's a level called lunch, club, and finally police. But police isn't the final level. No, there are a couple of other things. Later on, the game will become a bit more open. Oh, hold on, be patient, door. We'll get to you eventually. I do believe you get hurt if you touch that. So there's no need to. For now, more on resource management. Still can't select anything. Oh wait, that's because I've got auto-checked. We do not want to have it automatically distribute our energy like that. That might be bad. Well, we're going to need a very specific cocktail of energy by the last level. You'll see. Okay, so using the health, using energy and health, we can increase our maximum health. No, this is health regeneration and armor regeneration. Yes, we want both of that as much as possible. Although we also rely on this for our ammo regeneration. We can't just pick up ammo. We need to get the energy to regenerate it for us. And to get the energy, we need to kill other people. That's why we can kick people, although it seems more like we just give them a mean look. For now, it's very simple. We only have the bulldog, so that's the only one we'll be using. Have no artifacts, so no need to worry about energy distribution for artifacts. Now, that icon in the upper left, just below the energy icon, yes, as she said, that will show what reward, well, how close we are to unlocking the next reward. Those are weapons, I believe, mainly. I believe you get the artifacts by completing the levels. It's actually been a while since I played this, but let's roll with it. Hotel, here we come. New message. An artifact artifacts by completing levels, definitely. An artifact recently has been stolen from the bank's vaults. We found out that it was silver, and he is now in one of the hotel rooms. You'll need to find him and seize the artifact. Alright, so you see, this points towards the city, but danger, it's the destruction zone. Yeah, you don't want to go in there. You really don't want to go out there unless you have to. Think of it as an eternal curfew. I'll let your imagination run wild with what's out there for now. Here's a guardsman. I like those guys. They're the easiest enemy to dispatch. Welcome to Utopia Hotel. Everything in Utopia is Utopia something, by the way.
Anybody here?
Hello there.
Hey, excuse me.
Hello. Ah, yes, here's a bar. I think we might be able to regenerate by using these drinks. I think. Maybe. I can't remember. It's just a feeling that I had.
Excuse me.
Excuse me.
Hey.
Hey. So, our mean look can also, well, we'll see what it can do. I was going to smash that glass, but I don't feel like it now. It looks too nice. And there's a plant. There's an ashtray, which we can knock over. Okay, so that's going to be it for this part. Oh, there's some light there. Well, I'm glad that this place is quite well lit. I'm happy with that. Let's see. Next time, we're going to have to start exploring the hotel rooms for Silver and get his artifacts. Authorized personnel only, that's normal. We're going to have to be quite agile, too. We're going to have to crouch while running. Ah, that's how you do it. For some reason, I can get it to toggle onwards by holding shift, then crouch, then letting go of both of them, and then crouching again.
Well,
I'll have to keep that in mind, because we will have to crawl through some vents. So, for now, bye-bye!